In this segment, we'll talk about the arachnoid mater. Now, the arachnoid mater is the middle layer, and it is indicated here, right in this region. It's adherent. The top part of it is adherent to the dura. Forgive the space. I wasn't able to work with PowerPoint just to get it to stick up there as well as I wanted. But anyway, this is the arachnoid layer. It has an outer layer that's stuck to the dura and an inner layer that is stuck to the pia mater. It has these little trabeculae, and this is to represent the space that's created by and filled when you're alive with cerebrospinal fluid. So the arachnoid encloses the subarachnoid space. It provides a pathway and support for the incoming arteries and outgoing veins. And it has a specialization that we'll talk about towards the end called the arachnoid granulations. So on this image, on these images, we can see that the dura is present here, and the arachnoid is this filmy layer that you can kind of see in some of these areas. Okay. In life, it would be more suspended and thicker. Here you can see how if you pull up on the dura here, that you can see the blood vessels and the that are suspended in the arachnoid. Okay. The arachnoid granulations can also be seen in this region. And these are specialized areas. This is where the arachnoid actually pushes in to the dural sinuses that we talked about when we talked about the dura. And this is how cerebrospinal fluid exits the subarachnoid space and gets back into venous circulation. So in this image, we see the dura and the arachnoid in these regions here, and we see the arachnoid granulations. The arachnoid granulations are also here. This is the subarachnoid space, and the subarachnoid, the arachnoid granulations represent areas of the arachnoid that push into the dural sinus. And this allows cerebrospinal fluid to go from that subarachnoid space back into venous circulation and then drain. The balance of fluid creation between the creation of cerebrospinal fluid and the subsequent drainage of cerebrospinal fluid is very important, because fluids are not compressible, but your brain is. And remember, you're inside of the skull, which is a finite confined space. And so if you have too much cerebrospinal fluid, it can't get out through the skull, and it will eventually compress the brain itself, and which is a very dangerous situation called hydrocephalus. In the next segment, we'll talk more about the pia mater.